And if you were using stopping power, you could actually two-shot people up to 17.5 meters. That's right, which actually gave it the fastest time to kill of all the SMGs in a game where every gun killed fast. The MP5 is an iconic submachine gun that has appeared throughout the Call of Duty series, and it actually pops up quite a bit in movies and television thanks to multiple reasons: sleek design, reliability, and the compact size. But just how much has the MP5 changed over the years in COD? What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the Evolution series. Today, we are going to be deep diving in to take a look at the MP5 over the last, I'd say, decade or so, and see how much the German SMG has evolved or devolved, and also determine the best of them all. So be sure to let me know in the comments which MP5 is your favorite. Drop a like, make sure you have those notifications turned on, and here we go. So first, some real-world history for all of you. The MP5 was designed by German manufacturer H&K in 1964. Everybody knows that, right? Now, the gun got quite a bit of attention for its compact design, and over 100 different variants to better suit each combat situation were made. By 1966, it was being used in armed forces around the world, and it's currently in service by over 40 nation militaries. In 1999, H&K developed a successor called the UMP, but it didn't catch on nearly as well as the original, and the MP5 is still widely used today in 2020. Now let's jump back to Call of Duty. The first Call of Duty game to ever feature this iconic weapon was actually COD 4. It was unlocked by default in COD 4, and it was arguably the best submachine gun in the entire game, although there's a constant debate over, well, the community likes to talk about the AK-74U, versus the MP5. I don't think it's a debate. I think the MP5 was the best. It would deal between 20 and 40 damage, which made it a 3-5 shot kill with no stopping power, and a 2-4 shot kill with stopping power. It also fired at a respectable 800 rounds per minute, which made the time to kill very quick, especially in close quarter engagements. Now, the recoil, it wasn't awful, but it was also rather bouncy, and it was a little unpredictable, so it didn't really kick as much as certain other guns, but it was still kind of difficult to control with your thumbstick. So, most people stuck to close range engagements rather than try to tag from a distance, which made sense. It was an SMG, right? It was meant to be a solid all-around SMG in the game, and it filled that role perfect. In fact, it was so good that many people still think it's the best SMG in the entire game. And I know the AK-74U hit harder, and the Uzi fired faster, and the P90 had more ammo, but the MP5 was pretty good in every scenario, and on its own, it was still a really strong weapon. Personally, my only issue with it was the iron sights. They were a little too bulky for my liking. I like some clean iron sights, but you throw a red dot on it, and the problem is solved. It made a return in Modern Warfare 2. This time, it was the MP5K variant, and in real life, this variant was introduced in 1976 specifically for combat used in South America, but it later became a popular variant for police and civilian use due to it being a much more smaller and much more lighter version of the original. Now, the Modern Warfare 2 MP5K was unlocked at level 4 of the multiplayer, meaning everybody in the game would have access to it super early, but you didn't see it a whole lot online because it was designed by Infinity Ward to be kind of a starter weapon and not something you would actually use after you unlocked a bunch of other stuff. There were some strong guns in Modern Warfare 2, we all know that. It fired at 895 rounds per minute, 95 more than the COD 4 version, and it hit for between 20 and 40 damage with no stopping power. So, it had the same type of damage profile as the COD 4 version, but it fired noticeably faster. And interestingly enough, the MP5K had extremely intimidating range. And if you were using stopping power, you could actually two-shot people up to 17.5 meters. That's right, which actually gave it the fastest time to kill of all the SMGs in a game where every gun killed fast. So, why didn't you see too much of it online in Modern Warfare 2? Well, it had some drawbacks. The recoil, once again bouncy and unreliable. It also didn't help that the reload time was rather long at over 2.5 seconds for an SMG. That's not what you want. So while it actually had the fastest time to kill of any SMG in the game, it suffered in the handling department. Most people gravitated toward the UMP-45 or the P90 for close quarters combat. The next time we saw the MP5, it came back the following year in the original Black Ops. Once again, it was the MP5K variant, although this wasn't actually historically accurate. Like I said before, the variant was introduced in 1976, but Black Ops 1 takes place in the 60s. But I'm going to let it slide. For the third game in a row, it hit between 20 and 40 damage, 3-5 shot kill. But this time around, there's no stopping power in Black Ops to boost it up. So what you saw was what you got. As much as I liked it in Black Ops, it just really wasn't that special if you look back at it. It fired at 750 rounds per minute, slowest so far in the video, and it had some crappy range, honestly. Also, it had that bouncy recoil once again, but since the damage in the range didn't make up for it, a lot of people thought it wasn't a very good gun. Now, the hipfire was tight, but the reload, it was slow. An SMG with almost a full 3 seconds? No, that's not good. It's weird because everybody remembers the MP5K in Black Ops. When you look at it now with nostalgia goggles, which I like to do, it wasn't very good. To be fair, there was a lot of SMGs in Black Ops, and they were mostly crap. I can admit that. Black Ops is, the original is one of my favorite Call of Duties of all time, but I can admit the weapon balance, it was pretty bad, and the SMG category specifically suffered. It was fun to mess around with, but most people avoided it. They just used the AK-74U if they wanted an SMG. It was just pretty unimpressive all the way around. Then we get to Modern Warfare 3. Here it comes. Still underwhelming, unfortunately. It actually got forgotten a lot. Seriously, did you even remember the MP5 was in MW3? It was one of the least used guns in the game. Now, it wasn't bad, but what was the point? It was probably the most average middle-of-the-road gun in the game, and interesting, if you looked at the promo material for Modern Warfare 3, it seems like originally it was going to be the MP5K again, but for some point during development, IW and Sledgehammer decided to go with the base MP5. So in the campaign reveals, the MP5 has a grip on it, like the MP5K. In the early builds of the game, it has a 20-round mag instead of 30, even used the MP5K HUD icon. Now, I'm not really sure what made the devs switch their mind when the full game out to go back to an MP5. I guess they didn't want the MP5K to show up in 3 CODs in a row. I don't know. It was unlocked at level 4, and it shared similarities with the MW2 version, but it was toned down a bit. It fired at almost 900 rounds per minute, 42 to 20 damage, 3 to 5 shot kill, it's cool, but it perhaps had the sharpest range drop-off of all the MP5s on this list. You would hit for 42 at point-blank range. But the damage would almost immediately drop all the way down to the 20, so it would be a 4-to-5 shot kill in most situations. It's not good. The recoil? Bouncy and unpredictable. The magazine? It was the smallest in the entire SMG class, and the center speed? It was slow. In fact, the MP5 was outclassed literally by every other SMG in Modern Warfare 3. The MP7, better fire rate, better damage, bigger magazine, lower recoil, better gun. The P90, exact same damage profile with a bigger mag and almost the same fire rate, better gun. The UMP, it fired slower, but it hit harder with less recoil. Better gun. PP90, yeah, better gun. I'm not going to go into it. It just was. I mean, there was no reason to use the MP5 is what I'm getting at. Once you unlock the other SMGs, and nobody did. The high maximum damage made it okay in hardcore, but again, it was outclassed in every way by every other SMG because Infinity War, once again, wanted the MP5 to be a starter weapon. And now that brings us to Modern Warfare 2019, which has perhaps the best MP5 we've ever gotten, in my opinion. It's a beast of an SMG, it's unlocked right out of the gate, and it's hands down the best SMG in the game, and some say it's actually the best gun overall. Do you agree? Now, many guns in Modern Warfare, I mean, like the base stats of the MP5, they're not impressive, but it has good handling and the potential of attachments. It fires at 833 rounds per minute. It only hits for 30 to 17, but, I mean, you can get a juicy 1.6 times headshot multiplier and a 1.1 times chest multiplier. I said that all really fast, and that speeds up the time really fast to kill people. It does. It makes it a weapon of choice, especially for aggressive players. And it's one of the only guns you'll see in competitive play, thanks to its versatility. Now, some have called the MP5 to be nerfed due to it outperforming the other SMGs so dramatically, but as someone who's kind of out of the loop with the nerfs at the moment, I'll leave that discussion up to you guys in the comment section. Do you think the MP5 needs to nerf, or do you think it's okay? And regardless of your opinion, I think we can all agree that it's the best MP5 in COD history. If you don't agree, you can let me know why in the comment section. There you have it, my friends. That is a trip down nostalgia goggle lane, road, whatever you want to call it, about the MP5 and the evolution that it has had. Let me know what you guys want to see next on the Evolution series. I think we are cooking up an M1911. I think that's coming pretty soon, and I'm not really sure what else we have. You guys, let me know what you would like to see. It doesn't just have to be guns. We could do kill streaks that have been in multiple games, maps that evolved. I mean, I know we're cooking up a Nuketown one as well. Drop a like if you enjoyed, and I'll see you soon.